You guys ready? Would you go ahead and please swear in the witness?
Do you solemnly swear, under penalty of perjury, that what you are about to say is true?
Swear? I'd be happy to. Otunga, you are the biggest dick.
I'm not counsel. That kind of swearing.
My apologies. I'm new to all this. I swear to be truthful.
Let's proceed. Please state your full name for the record.
Seamus.
And your last name?
Lipschitz.
Really?
Yeah. You know, my mom was Irish and my dad was Jewish.
Okay, well, Mr. Lipschitz.
You know what the great thing about that was? Every Paddy's Day, we'd sing songs of Old Danny Boy and have a Nagila. Yeah, it was great. We'd eat that green matzo stuff. And we'd spend our days drinking and fighting, but feel very, very guilty afterwards.
We get it.
Now, and then we'd spend our nights trying to solve the age-old Lipschitz riddle. You know, it was like, if you're Lipschitz, what does your arse do?
If we could just proceed here, please.
My name is Lipschitz. I'm just joking with you.
Joking? You think this is a joking matter? Sir, this is a deposition. Now, I'd like to turn your attention to the night of September 3rd of this year. Do you recall it?
I do.
You were in Chicago that evening.
I was.
You utilized the maneuver referred to as the bro kick.
Si, senor.
Please let the record reflect that Seamus has just openly mocked my client.
Aren't we going to talk about the fact that his boss, Alberto Del Rio, jumped me in the ring after my match?
Alberto Del Rio is not the one being deposed here. Now, did you or did you not brogue kick my client?
I did. And if I had to do it again, I would.
Trust me, this is good.
He's trying to wind me up. He's trying to wind me up.
And how long have you been utilizing the brogue kick?
A couple of years.
Does the name Chad Patton mean anything to you?
Yeah, he's a WWE referee.
He's what I would call a defenseless victim that you severely attacked on April 6th of this year.
Look at that. They could at least airbrush that.
Do you know Daniel Bryan?
Oh, Goatface. Yeah.
Isn't it true that Isn't it true that at WrestleMania?
Yes! Yes!
Counsel, will you please control your client? Now, isn't it true that at WrestleMania you waited until Mr. Bryan's back was turned to then attack him with a brogue kick?
Correction. The bell rang, I waited for Daniel Bryan to turn around, then I attacked him with the brogue kick. The rest of it's kind of sketchy, but all I remember is it lasted 18 seconds. See that? Whole family were there. It was great. Time of my life.
Now, are you aware of the chronic neck pain that Chad Patton still suffers to this day?
Objection. My client is not a doctor.
Are you aware of the mental trauma experienced by Daniel Bryan?
Objection. My client is not a psychiatrist.
Nor does he need to be to know the mental trauma caused by the brogue kick.
Same objection. This line of questioning is bordering on the absurd.
And are you aware that the brogue kick causes extreme nerve damage and tingling in the extremities of your victims?
Objection!
Do you acknowledge that the brogue kick, a move that has been temporarily banned and should be permanently banned, is a dangerous, reckless, lethal weapon that clearly demonstrates the actions of a vile, careless, remorseless hooligan?
Demonstrates? You want a demonstration? I'll be happy to oblige. You see, the brogue kick doesn't discriminate against anybody. It could be a slimy, sleazy weasel, or a small coffee-sipping, Amelin chasing parasite. Or maybe I should sing Danny Boy.
Dial it down.
Or maybe I should do this. Oh! Relax, everybody. Let's have a party. Hava Nagila, Hava Nagila, Hava Nagila Vanishkima. Hey! Hava Nagila, Hava Nagila, Hava
nugget of an Eskimo.